there's just time. So is it wrong to dance this line? If your heart was full of love, could you give it up?
I was 12 years old when I moved to Canada. I lived in India my entire life, and moving was the hardest thing that I've ever had to experience. I was forced to leave my friends, family, and memories behind, and I wasn't prepared to begin a whole new life. My family was always very tight for money in India. My father worked while my mother stayed home and took care of me and my four other siblings. Life was rough until my father was offered a better paying job in Canada. My parents explained to us that there was better opportunity and that we would have a better future. The next thing I knew, we were packing our bags and heading to the airport. After a long flight, we finally arrived in Canada. We arrived mid-December with no money and no place to go. We found a small one-bedroom home located in a small town in Toronto. We slept on the floor and ate whatever we could afford. I already began to miss life back in India, but I knew not to complain, as I could tell my parents felt the same way. January 5th, to be exact, was my first day of middle school. I was nervous because I didn't know what to expect. I was different, and I didn't look like the others. I walked into my new grade 7 classroom and sat in the back corner. I was the first one there. When the teacher arrived, she called me up to the front of the class. I looked up to see people whispering. I proceeded to introduce myself as she instructed. When I announced my name to the class, people began to laugh for no apparent reason. The teacher commanded the class to settle down and led me back to my seat, where I sat in confusion. I couldn't help but ask myself, what was it about me that was so funny to everyone else? At first, I didn't know what they were laughing at. It took me a little while to figure out what was going on, but when I finally did, I knew that I was never going to be accepted because I wasn't like the others. When it was lunchtime, I thought everyone had already gotten over making fun of the new kid, so I decided to ask a group of girls if I could sit with them. The girls just looked at me and pointed to a corner where the garbage can was, and as I was walking away, the sound of their laughter pierced my ears. For the rest of the day, I sat alone. When I got home that night, my parents asked how my first day was. I didn't want them to know about what happened at school, so I lied to them. I told them that everything went well. What they didn't know was that I had a terrible day, and I never wanted to step foot in that school again. Throughout the rest of the week, I started to get called names like brown girl, ugly, pig, loser. The list goes on. Because I was from another country, it made the whole situation worse. My classmates would say things to me like, people like you don't belong at this school, and why are you even here? No one likes you. I once found myself locked in the bathroom, crying and struggling to catch my breath. School had become my own private hell. The bullying began to escalate. They started throwing drinks and food at me at lunchtime. They began to taunt me about my hair, clothes, and face. I would continuously point out how it was different from theirs. On a daily basis, I was sworn at, told that my family should die, and told that I should kill myself. I repeatedly asked myself, why does everyone hate me so much? And sometimes I even wondered if they were right, if I really was all the things that they were calling me. The words began to crush me. I began to show signs of depression and anxiety. I felt abused. I felt tortured. I felt that I was being used for entertainment. A few months had passed, and each day I would return to school with another bruise, another slit on my wrist, and another name engraved into my soul. I felt horrible. I had completely forgotten the meaning of self-esteem. I hated everything about myself. I knew that I was a victim, but I couldn't help but blame myself. So come on, let's get the TV. One day in particular that has left a lasting impact on me. One day, we had swimming in phys ed. The teacher was always late for class, so she would instruct us to wait for her on the pool deck. I was standing alone when my tormentors began to surround me. Each of them grabbed one of my limbs and began to lift me into the water. I didn't know how to swim. I fought against them, but I wasn't strong enough to take down all of them by myself. They proceeded to throw me into the deep end of the pool, where they watched me struggle for several minutes as they laughed. Gasping for air, I began to sink lower and lower into the water. Shoulders, neck, mouth, nose. The next thing I knew, my whole body had been submerged in water. My vision began to blur, and the sunlight began to fade. I woke up in the hospital, and later found out that my lungs had almost completely filled with water, and I was very lucky to be alive. I almost died. They told my teacher that I fell in, and I said that it was true. I was too scared to tell them otherwise. I feared that by telling, the consequences meted out by the bullies would become worse. I didn't think that people would understand. Yeah, we're all wonderful, wonderful people. The bullying and tormenting continued. Each passing day was a new terror stepping foot into the torture. There are a few experiences that stick out in my mind as the worst days, but I went every day, and I did it without complaining because I knew there was no other way. I couldn't skip school without my parents finding out, and they were already busy with their new jobs and moving in. I dealt with it. I thought I was strong enough to handle it, but each day it was a new person, a new joke, a new insult, and a new emotional and physical scar. Months went by and the bullying began to die down. I thought that people had finally decided to leave me alone. I still had no friends, but I was okay with that because I wasn't dealing with any of the torture. Until one day, I felt as if I got punched in the face. The bullying started right up again. All the name-calling, the pushing around, but this time it was 10 times worse. I went home that day, and all I wanted to do was sit in my room and cry. I couldn't stand who I was anymore. I was sick and tired of everyone making me feel like I was worthless, like I didn't belong. It was almost the end of the year at that point, and I still had nobody. I figured that the only way I would ever be accepted was if I was anybody but myself. One night, when nobody was home, I locked myself in the bathroom and grabbed a bottle of pills from the medicine cabinet. I sat down with the pills in my hand as I counted to 3 and pushed them into my mouth. I sat there, slowly waiting for death's impending arrival as tears rolled down my face. I knew that if I didn't do it, I would hate myself even more. The next thing I knew, I woke up laying on the cold floor next to an empty pill bottle. I had failed, and I hated myself for it. I felt like I didn't belong in the world, so I thought everyone's lives would be better if I wasn't in it. I felt so alone, and sad, and hopeless, and tired, and overwhelmed, and fearful. Fearful of my own life. I was fully alone in the world. I attempted to kill myself because I was too frightened to reveal my suffering. Because I feared being physically attacked by my tormentors. Because I couldn't take it any longer, and I thought this was the only solution. I sat by myself for hours after attempting suicide. That's when I realized that death was not the solution. It would not be a relief to the suffering. I became conscious of the fact that if I wanted to relieve the pain, I would have to choose to live. I would have to reach out and find the courage to make tomorrow a better day than today. I needed to remember that there is always a light at the end of the tunnel, because even the darkest hour only has 60 minutes. I needed to realize that I was not alone. I needed to remember that what was going on in my life was only temporary, and there shouldn't be permanent solutions to temporary problems. Looking back, I learned a lot from these experiences. I learned to become strong and confident in myself. Even though they put me through tough times, they helped me find my true self. If I were to see my bullies today, I would thank them. I would thank them because I now know never to change myself for anyone else but me. I'm happy with who I am, and I'm going to keep it that way. be afraid, and always remember that suicide is never the answer. Once you are dead, you are gone forever. There is no going back. Everything is over. You don't have to live in pain anymore, but everyone else will. You think no one cares, but they do. Always be confident and stay true to who you really are. We cannot ever let a soul in the world tell us that we can't be exactly who we are, because everyone is unique and special in their own way. A time will come once you've battled the toughest times of your life and are at ease once again, where you will be so glad that you decided to keep on living. You will emerge stronger from this all, and I promise you won't regret your choice to carry on with life. Believe it or not, it will always get better. Sometimes you have to go through the toughest storms to get to the rainbow.
I wanna leave my footprints on the sands of time. Know there was something bad and something that I left behind. When I leave this world, I'll leave no regrets. Leave something to remember so they won't forget I was here.